Barkeep, what's the drunkest I can get for, $2?
For $2, I can let you drink everything that spilled in my overpour mat tonight. The Splat Mat Special.
That sounds terrible. Bring it. Third wheeling it, huh?
Huh? Oh, yeah, they're just friends from work.
You want some advice? Watch your back around those two.
Watch my back?
Couples are not to be trusted.
We just work together.
Yeah. It all seems innocent. Till one day, you're sitting in a bar telling a stranger about how your life got ruined.
Well, you don't have
to. It all started 4 months ago. Karen, Elizabeth Beale, will you do me the great honor of marrying me?
Look what you've done to Alphonse!
Could have been worse.
How?
Technically, she never said no. Maybe it was too soon.
Too soon? We've been dating for 3 months. Almost.
Well, I think anything under a solid decade is impetuous. If not, downright irresponsible. I'm sorry about this, man. This is such bad timing. I wish I could be here for you right now, but...
No, I know. Look, it's fine. I know how long you've wanted this job, so...
That one. If you ever find yourself in central Germany, you know, stop by.
Yeah, for sure.
Hey! Mind? We're having a modern male moment here.
Take your time, Mr. Sensitive. It's on my flight we're gonna miss.
Oh, shit. Okay, I got a bolt. You sure you're gonna be okay?
Yeah, I'll be fine.
Oh, listen, don't go falling for the first girl that comes along, okay? No, I know how you get. All that hopeless romantic shit will get you in nothing but trouble.
Trust me, any shred of romance that was left in me was ground to a bloody pulp yesterday.
Oh, good. I mean, not good. I mean, fuck. You know what I mean.
Well, auf Wiedersehen. Eat some schnitzel for me or something.
All right, be well. And stay out of trouble.
La 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 la. La 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 la.
Knock it off, butthead.
La 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 la. La 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 la. Asshole.
She won't let you out for one beer? Come on, what's that all about? No, I'm not calling your wife a bitch. No. Oh, come on, man. How long have we been friends? Okay, how long have we been acquaintances? Scott Teller, I bought you a futon a few years ago?
Last night I picked up the phone. Late call said you were alone. Crying to me about all the things that we said. Apologize for your words. Said you hadn't slept in days. Said that you need me and...
Hey, I'm Nina.
Hi, Nina. I'm Scott.
I know this is incredibly forward, but I think you're really cute, and I was just wondering if you'd maybe like to go out?
I'd love you. I mean, I'd love to go out sometime. I mean, not to say that I couldn't love you at some point. Just, you know, life is a very funny thing. You never know what's gonna happen next. Nina?
So I came back, opened my mind, decided to give you the time.
get a roommate.
You know, the best way for me to introduce myself would be to do a monologue.
Okay.
As she leads me to her bed, I see, for the first time, piles of pairs of pink panties.
Harold just has difficulty communicating with others. Mm. Don't you, Harold?
I'm sorry?
My vagina is unto the world's vagina.
I live just around the corner, so I can visit all the time.
Thank you.
Ryan Beckett.
Mary Kincaid. Hi.
Hi, Scott Teller. Nice to meet you.
So, this place is awesome.
I was looking for a change last year, so I moved downtown. I'm a senior product reviewer for Open Collar Worker. It's a magazine for work-at-home professionals.
How do you like working from home?
I won't lie to you. Gets lonely sometimes. Which one of you is interested in the apartment?
Actually?
Both of us.
To be honest, I'm not really sure about living with a couple. No offense, but it seems like it could get kind of awkward. Is everything okay?
Yeah. We've just been having a hard time trying to find a place.
Yeah, and I mean, really into the whole downtown loft thing, so.
Are you okay?
No, just your beard.
Yeah, that. It's just like a bastard. I don't know why I keep it. Someone on the street yesterday called me a Vermont guy. I keep meaning to shave it off, but I guess I haven't really had a reason to. Not since Karen. But I don't want to bore you with that story.
No, we're not in any rush. Scott, try us.
You can tell us, Scott.
Okay.
We sit around looking for flaws and diamonds. We sit around spilling our ice cubes on the lawn. We sit around fighting our way through the darkness. Where we waste our time, where we could be righting every wrong. And we chase heartbreak where we can see heartbreak don't belong.
Oh, drum roll please. Here it comes.
Considerably less creepy shut in with this look.
That's exactly what I was going for, thanks.
Well, this was really fun, meeting like this. We should get going.
We should. Hey, listen, here is our card.
Yeah, call us sometime if you want to do something or just talk.
Good luck with the roomie search.
Whoever you find is lucky to live with a guy like you.
Hey guys, let's do it. Why don't you move in?
Scott, are you sure?
Hey, you guys are the nicest people I've met, and let's face it, you're the nicest people I'm gonna meet. And this place is totally big enough for the three of us.
Scott, you are not gonna regret this.
We will totally keep to ourselves. It'll be like having just one roommate. Yeah.
Well, when can you guys move in?
This weekend.
Yeah.
This weekend.
Great, I'll see you then.
All right.
Awesome. Okay. See ya.
See you soon.
I can't believe how well our colors work together. We're both autumns. Is that fate or what?
Yeah. It looks great.
Give him a break, Mary. He's only got one X chromosome, which is why he is much more interested in this bad boy.
Oh. Holy crap.
Zing!
Well, I am just so glad to see that you two stayed together, huh?
Yeah, it really looked like you guys were on the ropes there for a little while, so.
Well, fortunately, Narissa has a high bullshit threshold.
Aww.
Come on, you two scallywags, join us.
What?
I'm so sorry. I know I always do this, I know I suck, hey. I'm so sorry, but it really isn't my fault. I was driving here from work and I was on the PCH and the traffic suddenly stopped. And there is a turned over beekeeper's truck from some almond farm up north, and there's a cop who's supposed to be directing traffic around the truck, and he's swatting at all the bees. Everybody gets confused, and there's like six more accidents, so there's honey all over all the cars, and it was just, Ted, it was not my fault this time. I swear to God, it was not my fault, okay?
Calm down, we have a couple minutes. Calm down.
That's the most ridiculous thing that I've ever heard. That's awesome. I'm gonna use that one next time I'm late.
Are you accusing me of lying?
No. That's what's perfect about it. You couldn't make that up.
You'd be surprised. I am the master of excuses.
All right. Oh, what's your best one?
My best one? Dude, it would dazzle you, and I don't think you could handle it.
I've got an idea. How about we have a date, Saturday night, 8 o'clock. Here, you come at 9:30 and dazzle me.
This guy's got game.
Yeah. Do we know this guy?
Okay, Leslie, these are my friends from UCLA, Ryan and Ned.
Friends, really?
Stop it, please. Hi, and this is our roommate, Scott.
He is a good man.
Mm-hmm. Vouchers. I like vouchers. But I gotta say no, because I am not into the one-on-one thing with a stranger.
Okay, well, we'll all go. All six of us. Right? Saturday.
We're busy.
Honey?
What? No, wait, wait, no, we are. We have that thing with Phil and Barbara Griffin.
We could go.
Yeah.
Huh?
Yeah, sure.
Chaperones. Are we on?
Okay. Why not? but we're late because of the bees, so.
Bye. Oh,
good, good. No chance for me to say anything stupid. I'll see you on Saturday.
Oh, Leslie Green.
Leslie. Scott Teller.
Scott Teller. Okay.
Oh, see you Saturday.
See you Saturday. Bye. See you Saturday.
Scotty Scott Scotterton over here. Scutterino.
Way to get back in the saddle, partner.
I say giddy up, huh?
Did you see that?
Hey, who's got two thumbs and is impressed? Nervous, buddy? Huh?
Butterbys?
Huh?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, a little bit, I guess.
I'd be nervous.
I'd be going apeshit. I'm would. Talking fucking apeshit.
Yeah, yeah.
Hi.
Hey.
Hey.
Hi.
Hey.
Flaming gorilla nipple?
No, that's okay. So you guys started without me.
Well, it was 5 o'clock somewhere, huh, right?
I don't even drink anymore. Of course, I don't drink any less either. Hi-oh, what are you drinking?
Well, just a glass of red wine.
Mm. Ooh, Scotty Dog is not much of a wine drinker.
Tannins, give him headaches.
He's more of a beer guy.
Thanks, guys, I can speak for myself.
Of course you can.
If there's anything Scott can do, it's talk. Mm. A lot.
Like, yap, 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 yap. He is a regular little chatterbox. Like a chihuahua. Show her.
Yeah, come on, say something, Hotshot.
Oh! Watch this. This will be good.
Here it comes.
Really? Have you been?
Brilliant!
Man should be a writer. Hemingway over here, yeah. Right?
Guys, really,
so how have you been, Les?
Oh, I've been good. I can't say I love being called Les.
Oh.
I know what you're saying there. I can't stand it when people call me Mayor. Yeah.
Yes.
It's like, what am I? Am I a horse?
No.
Am I some kind of horse, like a pony?
Or like some kind of mayor or something, you know? Like...
Guys, I don't think this whole double date thing is working out. We're gonna get going.
Why?
You guys are shit-faced.
How dare you?
That is silly. I am sober as a fucking judge.
I think it's fine. I mean, just a little drunk. We've all been there.
Oh, thank you.
Thank you.
Oh! Ah! Oh, God! You know what we gotta do?
Say it.
Mexican food.
Ah, it does sound good.
We have to go get Mexican food.
I don't know, guys.
We should do it. Should we Vamanos?
Yes!
Si, senor.
Vamanos? I know the best spot. We could take a taxi.
Yes.
And that way, we'll get fucking hammered.
Sofa.
King.
Hammered. Ah!
I love the sound of this.
Oh, boy. Somebody get this guy a fucking drink.
You should sleep with him.
Sleep with him. He's awesome.
Yeah.
They crack me up.
Ryan, what do you do?
Oh, Mary and I are in contract law. We're both paralegals.
Hmm.
But we'll probably be going back to law school soon, so.
Oh, what school do you want to go to?
Wait a minute. Diddling?
Yeah, diddling. You know.
Oh, I know what it means. I can't believe you just sat there.
I didn't!
Well, Stanford's the dream, but it's pretty expensive.
Fuck yeah.
You okay, Mary?
Oh, yeah. Stop foot.
Driver, turn left here. It's quicker.
And you didn't say anything.
What was I supposed to do? Let Leslie know that a finger banging was happening a foot and a half behind her? That's not first date material, bro. I mean, come on.
I'm sorry. Please continue.
So have you guys ever thought about one of you going to school while the other one worked?
Uh-huh.
What, you mean like one of us go and the other one stay?
Yeah, you know, take turns.
Yes. Yes. Definitely.
Well, sounds like Mary likes the idea.
Mm-hmm. Oh, wow. They're really drunk, aren't they?
Yeah.
She's a little, tired, so I think we're just gonna go home and hit the sackaroo, but you guys are cool to get home, right? Safely?
Yeah, we can do that.
Okay. I will check you later.
It's cool.
Oz lasagna.
Bye now. See you later.
That was weird.
You have no idea.
So the three of you spend a lot of time together?
Yeah. I mean, we have. Maybe that's a little strange.
I get it. I've been the third wheel with Ted and Arissa way more times than I want to admit.
Well, tonight notwithstanding, Ryan and Mary are good people. Very perky. Maybe a little too... perfect, if you know what I mean.
Well, the way Ted explains it, they might as well be the Antichrist.
What?
Oh, don't take Ted seriously. He is a cynic with a flair for the dramatic. Narissa says they're good people, and that's good enough for me.
Well, next time we go out, it's just the two of us.
Oh, so there's gonna be a next time, huh?
Yeah. You can't let tonight be the end of it. I mean, this has just been ridiculous.
What are you doing tomorrow?
Something with you, I hope.
Wow. You really play hard to get, don't you? Okay, well, in that case, you should come by at 6.
I'm there. Cool.
What?
Nothing. I just realized I probably should have waited till the end of the date to ask you on a second date, because now there's no build-up, there's no tension, there's no mystery. How great is that?
Wow.
Hey!
Scott! Hi, we are so, so, so sorry about last night.
Yeah, we were way over the line.
I don't know what happens to me when I drink. I just get so H-O-R-N-Y. Yeah.
And I am a total man-whore after 4 cocktails.
We practice hot monogamy. I'm what you'd call a monogamous slut.
One of the pillars of our relationship keeps it spicy. Mm.
Huh?
And it doesn't help that I rarely, if ever, wear panties for him.
No, it does not. You must think that we are total pervs.
The whole thing must just seem so tawdry.
Ooh, tawdry. Fantastic word.
It's awesome,
that
right?
It's an awesome word.
Guys, let's just try to establish and respect some boundaries, all right?
Can do, Mr. Magoo.
Absolutely. And to make it up to you, we made brunch.
Yeah, I can see that. I can see that from space.
Dig it in it.
Bon appetit. We need more eggs.
Excellent idea.
My thoughts exactly.
Guys, really, none of this was necessary. I... You know, the less we talk or think or remember about last night, the better.
You know, we just feel terrible that we ruined it for you with Lisa.
Leslie, and you didn't ruin anything. We're going out tonight.
Wow. 2 dates in 2 days. Jesus H. Christ, Scott, I thought we weren't going to rush into anything this time.
I'm not rushing into anything. It's more of a do-over date anyway.
Whatever. It's just like you want to get your heart broken again.
Scott, what about the guy code? I mean, you don't even call a girl the next day, let alone go out with her. You're never going to get rid of her now.
I'm not really a guy code guy, Ryan. No, I like to play it by ear.
Yeah, that's been real successful so far.
Mary?
Dude, she's kidding. She's kidding. I mean, you know, she is and she isn't.
I am and I amn't.
Look, thank you for breakfast, but I'd like to drop the subject now.
It's dropped.
Like a bad habit.
Like a hot potato.
Like an atom bomb.
Like a prom dress.
Like a mother...
Well, it looks like somebody got up on the wrong side of the bed this morning. Your eggs are getting cold, Scott.
Other lightweight vacuums are light on power. That's why Dyson engineered the Dyson Slim.
See y'all later.
Wait!
We have to come with you.
Why?
To apologize to Leslie.
That won't be necessary.
Well, I know it won't, but it would just make us both feel so much better.
Yeah, we got off on the wrong foot.
Such the wrong foot.
Okay. But you leave right after the apology, and absolutely no drinks.
Don't worry. We'll be good. I'm even wearing panties today. Oh.
Just keeps coming. Look, I really want to spend some time with her. Alone.
Right. Say, Ryan, what's the name of the Canadian rock trio that recorded the song Tom Sawyer?
Why, Mary, that would be Rush.
Which is exactly what Scott is doing with Leslie.
Okay, you guys clearly planned that, and that's just odd. Come on.
Stood you up, man.
Left you hanging.
High and dry.
I feel awful. This is obviously our fault.
Oh, man, this sucks. So what do you say we go get a drink or 12? Nurse the wounds, all you can do, really.
right?
Yes.
Yeah.
Shall we?
Hi. Are you here to see someone?
Yes, Leslie.
Leslie Galinsky?
Leslie Green.
Oh, Leslie G. You must be Scott. Come on in.
Thanks.
Oh, I'm sorry. Invited guests only.
Well, we're with Scotty.
I'm just a woodland nymph with five lines, so.
You made it.
Hey, yeah, I did.
Sorry to drag you by work like this, but we've been so pressed for time. I've had very little social life lately.
This is work?
Oh, yes. I do costumes. I am the seamstress to the semi-stars.
Cool.
But I thought maybe you'd want to see the dress rehearsal, so put together some snacks. And brought some wine and beer, because I know you are a beer man. Is that cool?
Yeah, that'll do.
Okay, well, let's get a seat.
Up, right? They did?
Yeah.
Okay.
Fantastic. Again, I'm sorry about Brian and Mary.
Just forget about it. I don't want to get worked up over it. I won't let some gut-wrenching, potentially job-threatening embarrassment ruin a good date.
Good date? Come on. This is undoubtedly the best date that I've ever been on.
Yeah, I kind of actually impressed myself tonight.
Yeah. I mean, the bar has been set ridiculously high. I'm clearly going to have to involve air travel on our next date if I even hope to top this.
Well, I don't know about air travel, but... How do you feel about a wedding?
Ours?
No. Ted and Narissa are getting married in 2 weeks, and I'm the maid of honor. And I don't have a date. And I kind of don't think I'm going to meet anyone I want to go with more than you before then. So, come with me.
Yeah, absolutely. Weddings are a total turn-on for chicks. You don't stand a chance after that.
I like this.
What?
That I can tell you that I like you and not have to worry that I'm going to regret it later.
No, you definitely won't.
I just feel like I don't have to play games with you. I don't have to couch anything.
I don't even know what couch means as a verb. So, no. You definitely don't have to do that. Take you home.
It's okay. As great as this date has been, I don't want to rush anything.
Me neither. I'll call you.
Okay.
Good night.
Yeah.
please just shut up?
Hey, there's the man.
Mary, is everything okay?
Everything's fine. Was it a good night?
It was great, after you guys stopped shouting at us.
Oh, we did hear.
Yeah, they heard in Cucamonga. What's with this plate?
Oh, little accident on my part. Long story. I will replace that. Nothing major.
Nothing major.
Were you guys fighting?
I told you, we don't fight.
It's not our thing, buddy.
I think they're clean, lamb chop.
I'll decide that, honey bunches.
Ryan, who are you just yelling at to shut up?
What? No one. What?
So, Scotty, was it a good night?
Did you tap that ass?
Mary.
Yeah? Oh, come on. Did you give her the old hot beef injection?
Mary, what the
hell? Did you make like Sam the Butcher and bring Alice the meat?
Jesus, Mary. Mm.
This sex talk have me heap big in the mood.
Oh, I love it when you talk caveman.
That was, Indian, dear.
No, don't be silly. Indian is like, oh, Korean hori, Mr. Curry Man.
Native American Indian.
Oh, Geronimo.
Come here. Good night.
Good night.
Your wigwam,
chief. I'm gonna trade you $27 worth of trinkets for that ass.
Scotty dog.
Hey, Leslie.
Have you been talking to Mary for the last 20 minutes?
Is it a problem?
No, it's just...
They're acting really weird last night.
In fact, I'm beginning to think they're just weird in general.
What are you guys talking about?
Oh, you know, girl stuff.
So, what are you doing Friday?
You want to hang out?
Yeah, I'd love to.
I hear you like the batting cages.
Where did you hear that?
I have my sources.
So, Friday is 7?
And by the way, I have now asked you out twice.
I know, and I'm way behind. And I have to log at least twice as many as you if I'm gonna feel even remotely like a man.
Well, get to work, lazy bones.
I'll see you Friday, okay?
Okay.
Bye.
Bye. Jesus, you guys hungry or something?
Oh, I don't know, Scott. Maybe we're just being weird.
Oh, weird that you would say that, because I've been feeling very weird lately.
That is so weird.
That's weird.
Weird.
Guys, is something going on? Is this, like, a thing?
She heard you tell Lisa that you think we're weird.
Leslie.
Leslie? Why do I have such trouble with that?
I do, too. It's like Lisa, Leslie.
But you had no right to hear that.
I was just... in the process of hanging up the phone, making sure you'd picked up the call and that it was connecting, and... Scott? Come on. Do you think we're weird?
Yeah. Yes. If you want to know the truth, yes, I think you guys are a little weird.
Us? I'm sure. Scott, I was a Gerber baby.
And I am from Marblehead, Massachusetts, idyllic.
Born and raised.
Yeah.
Scott, what is so weird about us?
Well, okay, for starters, the whole no fighting thing, it's just odd.
We're not into the conflict thing, Scott.
I'm just curious, do you want us to break up or something?
Right?
No, I don't want you to break up. But it's just that normal couples fight. And it's very healthy for the relationship.
Now I'm just confused.
I don't even know how to do that.
Okay, just... here, come here, all right? Okay, Mary, you sit here. Ryan, sit here, okay?
No, guys, come. Trust me here, okay? Sit apart. Okay? There. Now, clearly there was something going on last night, all right? So let's draw from there, right? Now, tell him what you think.
Okay. Brian, you were being a dummy.
Okay, I appreciate that you're speaking from a place of anger right now.
Thank you.
No, okay, look, tell her what you were really thinking last night.
Okay, Mary, I wish that you would shut your trap about the toilet seat.
Yes, very good.
Blabbermouth.
Nice. Okay, now, Mary, your rebuttal.
Freak.
Twat.
Asshat.
Bitch.
Shitheel.
Strumpet.
Jerk off.
Queef waffle.
Nadfucker.
Tampon rapper.
Mama's boy.
Bloody fucking.
Ow! Ah! You know, in the UK, that word's not really that big of a deal.
I know. Yeah.
But this is an important lesson on escalation. You know, you can't go from a slap fight to a C-bomb. And look, you had a fight, and you're not breaking up.
No.
It's God. You're right. We have a lot of issues that we repress, and you're right, we need to work on that.
Yeah. Thank you, Scott. I think it's clear that we both learned a lot tonight.
I can't tell you how much you mean to us, buddy.
Wow, well, that's really nice.
I'm just so glad we found you.
Come here.
No.
Let's go, let's go, it's on.
Hey.
You okay there, buddy?
You want to move on to free weights? Blast those delts?
Pump your lats?
Pound your glutes? Huh? What do you say?
Oh, no thanks. I'm done. What a coincidence.
We're done too.
Yeah. But you guys just got here.
Hey, we work hard. It's not long. That's how we roll.
Goddamn right it is.
Where you headed?
Mind if we come with?
No. I won't be necessary. My head's kind of hurting, so I'm going to go get some aspirin or something.
Golly.
Didn't think it was a crime to want to spend some time with a friend.
Yeah, I mean, if you want to be alone, just be alone.
War history.
Past tense.
Ghosts.
Pasta lasagna.
Peace.
Okay.
Out.
Later.
Okay.
Well, what time will you be home?
Let's go, it's on. Let's go alone. Let's go, we'll get it home. Let's go, I'm going off. Let's go right now. Let's go, we're going out. You'll never know until you go just what it's all about.
Damn, you're good. Our kids would be Hall of Famers.
We had 3 dates, you got us having kids?
Just an expression.
You never know.
You moving?
I have to. My apartment building is going condo.
How long do you have before you have to move?
Like 40 days.
Leslie, I know this sounds crazy and we haven't known each other that long, but move in with me.
What?
I'm serious. You can have your own room and, you know, it'll be like we're roommates.
Oh my God. I mean, what about Ryan and Mary?
To be honest, it's not really working out. I'll give them plenty of notice and it'll be fine.
I don't know. I mean, I guess I just need to think about it. This is so out of the blue, Scott. I'm gonna need, like, some time to... I think we should go back to your place right now.
Okay.
Because I don't want to wait another minute. Okay?
Mm-hmm. Happy birthday to me.
This is right here. Okay, there's one. Let me check and make sure Ryan and Mary aren't here.
Well, hurry up. Okay. Hurry up.
Oh, hey, where are you going?
I was gonna get us something to drink.
Oh, well, there is no time for that. Where's your bedroom?
I like where this is heading.
Slow down, what are you doing? Slow down.
Oh.
Hold on,
what?
Joe! Why are you going outside?
Who planned this?
That would be us!
Chicka chicka booyah!
Happy B-Day!
Did you take that picture while I was sleeping?
You just looked so peaceful.
We figured, since you don't have any friends, that throwing a rockin' party would be a great way for you to make some new ones.
Right?
No, that's very funny, but I have lots of friends, just not in L.A. right now, okay? Were you a part of this?
This is what Mary and I were talking about on the phone.
You know, right before you called us weird.
Yeah, thanks again for that.
Yeah.
How did you even know it was my birthday?
Well, you left your driver's license on the counter a couple days ago.
And so you just picked it up?
Dude, she wanted to know your middle name. What?
It's Paul.
Paul.
Everyone, it's Paul. Paul!
Do you two have any awareness of what personal space and privacy are? Is the idea of keeping your pesky noses out of my business so impossible for you to fathom? Good night, everybody. Thank you for coming, but there's no party. Good night.
Scott. 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 How could you do that to Ryan and Mary? They went to all this trouble to throw a party for you, and now, I mean, granted, I guess the people they invited aren't the coolest people on the planet, but they seem really nice. Can't you just be thankful that you have such good friends?
Lizzie, you don't understand, okay? There's something very, very wrong about Ryan and Mary.
What? What did they do?
Well, they... It's hard to explain, okay? But they're freaks, all right?
Wow. Okay, well, remind me now to throw you a surprise party.
Lizzie, wait, sorry. Please. I'm sorry, okay? Just wait. Everyone? I'm sorry about all of this. I hope you stay. Please stay. It didn't mean a lot to me. I'll be honest. I don't have any friends right now in LA. So I didn't tell the few people that I do know about my birthday because I was afraid that I would look like a complete loser if I didn't have anybody to celebrate it with. I'm glad you're all here, and I hope you'll stay and forgive me for lashing out at you. And let's have some fun. DJ, drop it like it's hot.
I'm sorry.
It's okay.
You're not gonna leave, are you? I bet the DJ can play some Norwegian black metal. Maybe some Limp Bizkit?
Limp Bizkit is a deal breaker.
does live with them. I thought you were kidding.
Wedding, you promised. Remember?
I need to talk to you.
Hi.
I'm...
Hi.
Thank you. Thank you.
Hey, Ted. You have history with Ryan and Mary. Can I talk to you about them?
You're gonna want something much stronger than beer.
Okay, I'm not even gonna tell you what I had to promise Ted to get him here. You know, it's not that I mind doing it, but you... I'm not gonna tell you.
The joys of a long-term relationship.
Girl, you have no idea.
No, I don't.
Oh, speaking of which, what's going on with that one?
Yeah, that's the thing. Scott asked me to move in with him.
Jeez, he doesn't waste any time. Wait a minute, what did you say?
Well, kind of leaning toward yes.
Not again, are you serious?
It's different this time.
How is it different?
Because I'm going to wait to commit to a decision.
Good, wait.
Until after we go to your wedding together.
A week, you're gonna wait 1 week, that's the difference?
A week is long. Ish.
Oh my God. Have you even...
No.
So you're gonna live here?
No. It's his birthday tonight.
Okay.
And so I'm thinking, you know, if he plays his cards right, like...
Oh my God. Oh my God.
Okay, well, then we're gonna need this.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Let's open that.
Let's open it. Because we're both gonna be busy.
Gilder.
We need to talk.
You get the olives?
How can you think about olives at a time like this?
Well, what am I supposed to put in my martini, love? A pork chop?
Just shut up and come with me to the bathroom.
Okay.
Have a cocktail.
See, they even go to the friggin' can together. Let me ask you one thing. Have you ever once seen them apart?
No, I guess not. Not really.
No, of course not, because they, my friend, are a couple monster.
A couple monster?
They go to lunch together. They go to the gym together. They go to bars together. They commute together. I heard they share a cubicle at work. Not an office. That might, a cubicle. That's not right. And the sick part about it is, because they spend all of their time together, they have absolutely nothing left to talk about. Nothing to keep them from going lighthouse crazy. That's why they latch.
Latch?
Back when I knew them, they spent all of their time with this girl, Amy. Amy was like the buffer between them. She was their third wheel. She was the one they could talk about their day with. She was the one that they could deflect all their weird fuck tension onto instead of each other.
So what happened to Amy?
Don't know. She got wise, got out, maybe they cooked and ate her. Who knows? But the important thing is, dude, you are the new Amy. And from what you've told me about them trying to screw up your dates with Leslie...
No, I didn't say that they were trying. They nearly did.
Think about it. If you end up with Leslie, they are out of the picture. They are clearly not going to let that happen. And let me tell you one more thing. If I want to make you look like a loser in front of a potential girlfriend, this is pretty much exactly the party I would throw for you. Happy birthday, Amy.
And that's when I realized they were trying to sabotage my relationship with Leslie.
I don't know, man. Sounds like they were just maybe trying to keep you from rushing it, like they said they would do.
You're listening to Ted? Leslie told you he was a cynic.
Plus, you planned to kick him out. That's a pretty douchey move.
Hey, whose side are you guys on anyway?
Right now?
Don't answer that until you hear the rest.
Well, thanks again for helping with the table.
Have fun, right, you guys. Two. Drive safe.
Yeah, get home carefully now.
Oh, that was some party.
Well, gosh, that was fun, huh?
Wasn't that fun? Tables are inside. Guests have all left. It's all good.
Say, Leslie, do you need a ride somewhere, honey? It doesn't matter how far it is. We'd be happy to take you.
Oh, I think I'm gonna stay for a little bit.
Wonderful.
You know,
We need to make sure that we do this all the time. Mm. The four of us just hosting these little shindigs.
Mm-hmm.
The four of us?
Oh, well, we heard the big news and we could not be happier. I mean, this place is plenty big enough for four.
When you moving in, Lisa?
Leslie.
God damn it.
It's okay, honey.
Hold on, guys. There's some stuff we need to discuss first.
What stuff?
Yeah, what kind of stuff would that be?
I mean, I'm assuming she'll live in your room, go in a fourth on rent and utilities, buy TP when it's her turn. And besides that, what is there really to discuss?
Look, this is not how I wanted this to come up.
Hmm, why not?
How did you want it to come up, Scottsdale? Were you gonna shoot us an email?
Yeah, or maybe you're gonna blog it on your blog?
Can we just talk about this another time?
Scotty dog, you seem a little tense. Are you sure you're okay?
Darling, I think maybe we should discuss this under the light of a new day.
You know, honey, you're right.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Let's go.
Good night, roommates.
I'm so sorry that happened.
No, I'm sorry. I said something to Narissa, and she must have said something to Mary without realizing it was whatever.
Just
wait. It's the fall.
Ryan. Hey. Listen. Okay, tonight, I beg you, while Leslie's here, could you please not...
Please.
Please don't.
Sounds like... How many syllables?
Is it bigger than a bread box?
Huh?
Please don't have sex while Leslie is here.
What?
Why not?
Because the sound... The noise that you two make, it's insane. Both in the volume and the graphicness.
Scott, have you been listening to us have sex?
Shh, no, I haven't been listening. I can just hear it.
How many times, Scott?
Every? All right, I turned my music up, but I can still hear it.
This is creepy. If we had known that you were eavesdropping on our sex...
I knew what you're trying to do. You're trying to break me and Lisa up. Leslie!
Hard name.
It is.
It is. Yeah.
We are not trying to break you up, Scotty. We are just trying to slow you down.
Like we said we would.
No rushing, remember? Huh?
That deal is off.
God damn it, Scott! No one wants to see it work out between you and Leslie more than Ryan and I. But you are screwing everything up!
What am I screwing up?
You asked her to move in with you after two dates.
Two?
Come on, man! Couldn't scare her away any faster if you told her you were a Nazi sympathizer who's into fondling puppy balls.
Or a chronic masturbator.
Yeah, with a scat fetish.
Into she-males.
And furries.
Fukaki.
Tentacle porn.
Good. It was for your own good.
This is for my own good.
Come on, I got you. Just get it.
Eat ass cake, bitch!
How dare you, sir!
Anything but the
world! Don't let him go! I got him! Scott!
Oh, shit.
Oh, gosh, this was... fun!
Oh, it is never a dull moment here, let me tell you.
I'll admit that this probably looks kind of bad.
Yeah, but, you know, just playing...
Tomfoolery.
Shenanigans.
Roughhousing.
Little, no big biggie. You know, you, want some cake?
No. Thanks. I'm gonna go.
It was great to see you, Leslie.
See you soon, roomie.
Can I drive you home?
That's okay.
I know this looks insane, but it's like they said, you know, we're just... playing around.
You're delicious.
No, you're delicious.
We're still on for the wedding next week, right?
You're like a cupcake.
I don't know.
Listen, Leslie, this is not me, okay? None of this is. Just please give me one more chance without anybody else around, just me.
We're still on for the wedding. I'll see you at the wedding.
You want to hang out before?
Let's just stick with the wedding. I mean, you got this thing going on with your roommates that you need to work out.
I know, I will. I promise.
Okay.
Okay.
Bye.
Come on. Be. Yeah. Right. 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 Right.
Get there.
Hi!
Hey, great party, isn't it? Huh?
You two are sick. I want you out of this apartment. I want you out of my life.
Really?
We love you!
I didn't see them at all that last week. I assumed they'd just gone away for good.
Well, did they?
Is herpes?
No.
It's fine, right?
Well, it was a beautiful service.
Aside from your little outburst, yeah, it was lovely.
Yeah, I'm sorry about that. I just couldn't believe they had the gall to show up here.
Who?
Ryan and Mary.
I did the guest list with Nora, so Ryan and Mary weren't invited.
Yeah, like that would stop them. The hell did they go, anyway?
Who?
Ryan and Mary.
Okay. I have to go do photographs. Just stay here and try to be sane-ish.
What are you two doing here?
Making out? What does it look like we're doing?
Weddings make me so horny.
Of course! Everything makes you horny. Toaster ovens make you horny. You were not invited.
That is never gonna stop us from helping out our good buddy.
Friendship does not wait for an invitation, mister.
And besides, we have a contract.
Contract? Is null and void. Same as our friendship.
Unappreciative asshole!
Yeah.
Scott! What are you doing?
Leslie, I didn't bring this gift, but it has my name on it.
Why would that be?
Now you see, Ryan and Mary placed this gift with my name on it to set me up to make me look bad.
How does a gift make you look bad?
See, that it's not a gift. It's a trap. It's probably a box of tainted pork or dog shit or angry bees. I have to get rid of it.
Are you completely insane?
No,
young man, any reason you're absconding with the gift I brought?
I'm sorry, but this isn't your gift.
I assure you, it is.
Scott.
Now look, you bizarre human being.
Okay, Scott, you're making a scene.
This package contains a ridiculously expensive Williamson.
Just give him the gift. Give him the gift.
It's Leslie Greenstein.
Remember placing it all that.
Why is he picking on Dr. Cooper?
An hour ago. If you don't believe me, make a complete ass of yourself and open it.
Oh, we're way beyond a complete ass situation.
Leslie!
Oh my God!
What the fuck?
Leslie, come on. Look, this isn't me, okay? I'm not usually like this.
What are you usually like?
Normal. I swear, this is Ryan and Mary, okay? They're trying to keep us apart.
Why would they want to do that?
Because they need me. They need a third wheel to keep sane. That's why they keep trying to scare you off, so that they can have me all to themselves.
And how did you come up with this incredible theory?
Actually, Ted said it.
You're gonna take anything Ted says seriously?
But it makes sense. They say they're trying to keep me from rushing into anything with you, but...
But we were rushing! I mean, the fact that we were even considering moving in together after a couple of nice dates, that's rushing. I mean, I was willing to consider it because I...
Wait, was? Why are you speaking in the past tense like that?
Because I don't know you, Scott. I don't know you at all.
But it's Ryan and Mary.
Scott.
Leslie won't return my phone calls. I haven't been back to the apartment. Probably up there waiting to strike again. Jackals.
Well, they did kind of have a point.
What point?
Well, about the rushing it with Lisa.
Leslie!
Sorry. Maybe they really thought they were doing the right thing. I mean, sure, they're a little strange, but, you know, their hearts were in the right place.
Have you heard a word that I've said?
Have you?
Have you?
Yeah, what lousy friends we must be. Of course, you know all about being a lousy friend, huh, Scott?
Me? After everything we've been through, the good times, we helped you rebound, man.
We were just trying to help you like we promised you we would, and you treated us like we are a couple of raging lunatics or something.
Just put your keys on the counter. Both of them?
We only had the one.
Of course. Why would you need two? Probably share a toothbrush.
You'll be happy to know we'll be packed out by tonight.
Super.
I'll never hear from us again.
I want you to sign this contract. You said that I will not hear from you again. I want to make it official.
There, prick.
Thanks, bitch.
Choke on it, ass.
Shh. We have a contract.
Ryan. It is a tragedy that we can't talk to Scott, because we can't tell him where Leslie's going.
That is a shame. What? I heard that she's leaving L.A.
I heard the same thing.
What? Oh.
No. There's something that you two know and you're not telling me. Fine. Now tell me.
We overheard Leslie talking to some friends at the wedding after you left.
You stayed after I left?
Duh.
Open bar, dude. Come on.
She said she needed to get out of L.A. and she decided to go work with her sister.
Where?
If we tell you, you have to promise to forgive us.
Fine. Huh? I forgive you. You're forgiven. Now tell me.
Not so fast.
I got it.
By signing here, you acknowledge that we have acted entirely in your best interest.
Fine. I'm willing to buy that for now.
And that we really do care about you as a friend.
Okay, yes, whatever.
And if you go after Leslie, we get to come with you.
No way, uh-uh.
Dude, your piece of shit car will never make it. You need us.
And company.
No one likes to travel alone, huh?
I can rent a car, and trust me, traveling alone really beats the alternative.
Suit yourself. Just would have been such a great opportunity for Ryan and me to explain to Leslie that we caused all of this and not you, but hey, we don't...
Seriously?
Yeah.
We want out of this friendship. That means no loose ends, no unfinished business.
We seek closure, nothing more.
Nothing more.
Huh?
Okay. We'll go together. Just whatever, whatever it takes. Just tell me where she is.
Okay, I'm gonna need you to sign here and initial here and here and here.
That one too.
Good eye.
Thank you.
You guys are sick. Okay, now, tell me where she is.
She went to work for her sister's theater in Oregon.
Okay, where in Oregon?
You're gonna find out when we get there.
Freaky, freaky road trip!
Yeah!
Blah!
The love we have will never fade away. If ever two hearts were meant to be, forever in love, it's you and me. Every lonely night
is
like eternity.
You're tailgating.
I'm not, sweetheart.
Please back up, dear.
Damn it, woman, I know what I'm doing. Shrew.
Assrod.
Harpy.
Nancy boy.
Slut.
Fart knocker.
Whore!
Fuck stick.
I fucking love this fighting shit.
I do too, it's amazing.
Scott, what's the plan with Leslie?
I don't really have a plan, I'm just gonna play it by ear.
Scotty, you gotta have a game plan. We made a plan a long time ago. We've stuck to it. How do you think we've been together all these years, huh?
Just because you've done something for a long time doesn't mean you're doing it well.
Yeah, look at the Clippers. Hi-oh! Ha-ha! Burn, right?
Watch it, laughing
boy. I was talking
about
the Clippers. I wasn't talking about us. Jesus Christ, fine.
Ryan, pull off here. Let's stay for the night.
Dude, we're like not even halfway there.
If we stop now, it's gonna take us 2 days to get there.
I know. I've got a plan.
Oh, you got a plan now. Okay, all right, Mr. Plan. Room service.
Land shark.
Ow! We were thinking, since we're on vacation, maybe we should get a little drinky-poo.
Huh? I'll go, but only with Ryan.
What?
Huh?
I want to go out for beer, but just us guys.
Well, do I smell really or something?
Tonight I'll go out with Ryan. Tomorrow I'll go out with Mary. Alone.
Why?
Because couples do things separately.
Well, did you ever think that maybe we just enjoy each other's company more than most couples?
Most couples spend a good percentage of any relationship sick of each other's face. That's just part of being in love.
That is not a part that I'm interested in. But I do want that drink.
What do I do?
I got a triple pole in my bedroom, and I like the way you drop it low. What you trying to do, shorty? Boy, I can tell that you're down for whatever. If you think that you can handle me, I'm trying to
go. Never really took you for a stripper type.
Oh, no, I've never been to a strip club before. Ooh. 11.
11 what?
11 breasts I've seen.
You've only seen 11 breasts?
I mean, you know, in real life, I've seen more on, you know, TV and magazines, the internet. 13.
Why is this an odd number?
I saw one of my grandma's when I was a kid.
Wish I hadn't asked.
Nana, Mary Naturally, Wendy Harper, Tracy Price, Teresa, what's her name, and these strippers, yeah. 14, even number, boom.
And these other girls were what, exes?
No, Mary's the only girl I've ever dated. They were girls Mary and I had three ways with.
You've had three ways?
Seven.
The other four were with...
I should have known.
Oh, thank God you're here.
Oh, I see. You're already out looking for a better offer, you motherfucker,
Mary,
son of a
come
bitch,
on.
Asshole!
Look, Ryan's not scamming. And trust me, this is not the kind of place one goes to for a better offer.
I turned my back for 1 second and you were out philandering with strippers? I am not a prude, Ryan.
Yeah, no shit.
Excuse me, Scott, but this is beyond the pale. Simply beyond the pale.
Mary, look, okay, I don't know how you got here, but you have to leave. You have to show Ryan that you trust him.
Well, how can I trust him when he's sporting a chubby?
Mary, come on.
Come on, what? You want me to act like it's no big deal that my man's half-mast? It is a big deal.
We're just having some guy time, all right? He'll keep it in his pants.
Uh-huh.
I promise.
And if it's any consolation, as you can see, I am completely flaccid now.
We all are, Ryan. We all are. Don't wait up for us, Ryan.
I couldn't find the, I was just trying to... If you guys see my gym membership card, just, give that to me. Okay. I'm gonna go. Okay, have fun.
Let's fall in love. Let's fall in love.
This place is like an advertisement for choosing a partner at a young age. I'm getting hepatitis just being in here.
That's the spirit. Look, I want you to have a conversation with one of these fine gentlemen.
Why?
Because I want to see how you talk to a man that isn't Ryan.
Scott, this is silly. Can we just go home?
Hey there.
I can't.
Pretty lady. Can I buy you a drink?
Scott.
Could you just give us a moment, please?
Sure.
You have to get rid of him. He's just trying to get in my pants.
So? He's not going to. It's not like you're tempted to sleep with him or anything.
I'm tempted to fuck his brains out. I'd fuck him. I'd fuck that guy. I'd fuck the guy air guitaring back there. I'd fuck everybody I could see right now because I just want the chance to be with somebody else. This is the reason I cannot be trusted without Ryan around me at all times. Just once. I want to be with another guy without Ryan in the room. Can you understand that? I am so sick of fucking the same person over and over and over and over again.
Wow. That was Frank. She's gonna take a rain check on the whole talking thing. Thanks, though. Watch it.
And I need another. Excuse me.
All I'm saying is that both of you clearly have some issues that you're not addressing with each other.
But what happens if we address them and then we break up?
Look, relationships take work, real work. You can't just pretend that everything's okay so you don't have to deal with the hard stuff. You have to be brutally honest with each other.
Doesn't that hurt?
It can. Love hurts. But it's worth it. And that's why I'm chasing after a girl who probably won't even take me back. Because if there's even the slightest chance that she will, I have to risk it. We can't play it safe all the time.
That's what it is with Ryan and me, isn't it? We play it too safe. We're so afraid of this thing failing that we don't deal with it.
Anoptophobia.
Fear of being alone. Why'd you do this?
Do what?
Try to help us, our relationship.
Well, at first it was because I figured the only way I was gonna get you two lunatics out of my life was if you got your shit together. But actually, I like you guys a lot, and I want you to be happy.
You're a good friend, Scott.
About the menage thing,
mm-hmm.
I don't know if you two ever talked about, you know, me in that way.
Oh, no. Never.
Okay, good. Because that would have been a little weird.
Yeah.
Any particular reason why not?
This is it. This is where Leslie is.
Are you ready?
Not in the least.
Well, good luck.
Skateboarding with your costume on. If I have to fix your butt again, I'm gonna kick it. Capiche? Okay, now get out of here. Go.
Hi.
Hi. What are you doing here?
I wanted to clear some things up. Can we talk?
Okay. Okay, but just not here. Just. I've never been stalked before, so if you could give me, like, an idea of how long this might take, because I only have 40 minutes for lunch.
I'm not stalking you. At least not in a creepy way.
There you are. Hi.
There's nothing creepy about this at all.
Hi.
Hi, Leslie. Mary and I just wanted to make it clear that we did do everything Scott said we did.
We thought we could control everything for him, take away the risk of getting hurt.
Thank you, guys. I've got it from here.
Just like we've been trying to do in our own relationship for years.
But you can't do that. Mm-mm. Nobody can. A wise man once said to me, love is all about taking chances, even if it hurts.
So,
which is why Mary and I have decided
to split up.
Just for a while.
It's just a trial thing to see if we're really meant to be together. So if we can take a chance.
Maybe you guys can too.
It was really great meeting you, Leslie. And we are sorry about all of this, but I have a hunch you two are gonna be just fine.
Hasta lasagna.
So, you're not a total psycho, but your friends are.
Yeah, something like that. Can I buy you lunch?
I am pretty hungry and broke. So, yeah, okay. Oh, but this does not mean that I'm moving in with you.
Right.
And sex is, like, way down the road, and we're not even kissing anytime soon, and we have to completely start over from, like, the very, 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 very beginning, and there's no guarantees.
That's exactly what I wanted to hear.
Okay. Okay. I'm glad we talked.
Yeah, me too.
Oscar goes to...
Oh, you were fantastic.
No, you were fantastic, and they totally bought it.
Well, love is all about taking chances, even if it hurts. Give me a fucking break.
Oh, we're gonna break up. We're just gonna give a trial breakup, a little trial breakup thing.
Just to see if we really are meant to be together, you know.
Oh, my God. He'll be back.
Well, I live in Los Angeles. She said you drive in this horrible traffic. Man, you can't hear above the racket.
from downtown. Los Angeles. Yeah, well, I live in Los Angeles. You know that I live in Los Angeles. Well, I live in Los Angeles. Thank you.